from finance to manufacturing, from logistics to healthcare, we are entering a new era of knowledge economy, which is driven by the need of making smart decisions based on domain knowledge, data, and analysis. For example, how to design, test, and deploy trading strategies that can make profit with controllable risk. How a company can make investment decisions to hedge against the risk. How to set the price of hotel or other perishable and seasonal products and services. Hi, my name is Jiheng Zhang. I'm the UG coordinator of the Department of Industrial Engineering and Decision Analytics. In this video, I will show you what IDA is all about. Making the right choice is very important for your career and for your life. Via a few concrete examples, we want to show you that IDA is an important area in modern society. In addition to being relevant, the area by itself is interesting and intellectually challenging. Moreover, if the topics interest you, IDA will lead you to a rewarding and fulfilling career. Our mission is to build a solid foundation of possible skills in modeling, data, and analysis to equip students with domain-specific knowledge to launch a successful career in the knowledge economy. With the availability of data and fundamental IT tools, what does it take to solve a real problem? First, you need to know the domain knowledge related to this problem. If you want to solve an investment problem, you need to be familiar with the definitions and properties of securities and other financial instruments. If you want to improve the efficiency of a supply chain, you need to know how information, products, and money are transmitted along the chain. The domain knowledge by itself is not enough. You need to have the hacking ability to utilize modern database and programming to store and process data at large scale. In order to see the inside of the data and to create value, you need to build models to model how underlying business works. In this way, you can perform analysis and see how different decisions will affect the key performance indicators in this domain area. In fact, oftentimes, you need to use hacking ability again to utilize modern programming language such as Python to compute the optimal solution. So a good solution to a real problem lies in the intersection of these three areas. Our curriculum builds on a strong core and includes four relevant application domains across the modern economy. These four application domains will help our students to successfully launch their career in a wide range of industries where they may find their interest. Moreover, the skill sets our students acquire through the program are extremely portable because of the ubiquity of the methodologies introduced in the core courses. For those who are interested in pursuing postgraduate studies, our program also provides a solid foundation. Next, I will elaborate on each application domain and the core. Financial engineering is an interdisciplinary subject which applies quantitative method to solve finance-related problems, including the design and pricing of financial derivatives. Hong Kong is the third most important financial center in the world. This area is extremely important for the local economy and global. What you see in the video is how a financial instrument, a stock, an option, or even a cryptocurrency is traded electronically. On the left, it shows the prices and volumes of orders that are willing to sell or buy a certain instrument at the moment. What you can see is that orders arrive, are executed, or canceled at very high frequency. In fact, things happen at the time resolution of microseconds. Anyone who wants to design a profitable trading strategy needs to be able to handle data of such a vast volume at such a lightning speed with sophisticated mathematical models which can capture market dynamics, in addition to understanding how financial markets work. The application of financial engineering goes beyond the financial industry. Cathay Pacific experienced a big loss a few years ago due to a failed hedging strategy. We will teach students to use financial engineering tools to hedge against the fluctuation of oil price, which fluctuates violently depending on the global economic and political situation. In this way, Cathay can focus on the business what they're good at. In fact, such a hedging strategy is useful for any business facing uncertainty. For example, how to use hedging strategies for McDonald's to offer a stable price to customers while the chicken meat price fluctuates violently on the commodity market. Blockchain is an emerging area which has already had a profound impact in our real financial systems. In a nutshell, blockchain is a technology using a chain of blocks to process and verify transactions. Recent development shows that such a technology can be extended beyond financial area and to be used in any applications where trust and consensus are needed. To master this technology, you need to know three things: cryptography and the basics of network, which is what I called domain knowledge; programming, which is what I previously called hacking; last but the most important, models that reveal how it works. In this way, you can utilize and probably even improve this technology. I just want to quickly demonstrate one particular aspect, the security. Everyone on the network reach consensus by sticking to the longest chain. However, malicious people can create the bad chain to attack the system. When the bad chain exceeds the good chain, we call it a successful attack. It turns out that the probability of a successful attack can be calculated based on random walk model, which will be taught in one of our core courses. Consulting service is a broad area, including revenue management, dynamic pricing, service operations planning, and capital allocation. This area plays a very critical role in maintaining the global competitiveness of Hong Kong companies. It is, in fact, a very fast-growing sector. I expect most of our students will be able to find a job in this emerging area, which is extremely important. One example is the pricing strategy for perishable products, services such as air ticket or hotel. The demand for hotel depends on a lot of factors, including weather, season, competitors, and the economic situation. So the question is, given all the data and IT tools available in modern technology, how can we determine a price so that revenue is maximized? If we are able to increase our revenue by only a few percent, this would lead to millions of dollars of profit for large hotel chain. In fact, pricing strategy has become a key to the success of this business. The third area is engineering management, which combines engineering and business management. Studying this area focuses on applications of scientific and technology management for design and performance analysis of systems. For example, there is a quality and cost trade-off in a production line. The question is, how can we manage the quality of the production line in the most efficient way? You can see on the left picture our Professor Richard So designing hearing devices for humans. On the right is the Tianjin CTF Tower, and our Professor A.J. Janeja is involved in one of the projects to design the outside glass architecture using GPU computing. Last but not least, logistic management, one of the four pillars of Hong Kong's economy. Here I need to clarify that logistics is not about driving trucks around. It is about management of the flow of goods, information, money, and people. Modern business requires a systematic and scientific approach to make such management effective and efficient. Topics in logistic management include logistics and freight transport operations, transportation systems, global supply chain management, and logistics and inventory planning. The guiding principle of designing the core is to equip our students with a set of portable skills which have a wide range of applications in the knowledge economy. Our core contains a sequence of data-related courses: probability, statistics, and predictive analytics. Probability helps students understand and analyze the randomness in our world. Statistics helps students combine their probability knowledge and the data to analyze patterns in real data. Predictive analytics, as an advancement of statistics, teaches students the principles and applications of various machine learning algorithms. The sequence of the courses will enable students to analyze data and identify insights from data. Simulation is another course that uses computer programming to simulate, for example, a trading strategy, advertisement policy, pricing strategy, to see what the result would be. This will provide a so-called crystal ball for our business so that we can test all kinds of strategies without really doing it in a risky world. Building on probability, stochastic models introduce tools to systematically model and analyze gambling games, stock markets, manufacturing, and supply chains. Given data and all kinds of tools, we now can analyze, identify, or see the inside of the business. But more importantly, we need to know what to do, and the prescriptive analytics is the course for this purpose. This course teaches students how to come up with optimal strategy by introducing optimization theories and how to use Python to perform computing on various application models to show students how we can make the best decision in real business. I hope by now you have a clear picture of what our program is about. We hope the strong core and the up-to-date application domains will equip you with portable skills that can be applicable in a wide range of industries where you may find passion. Another reason to study at IEDA at HKUST is that we have a world-class faculty who have graduated from top universities around the world, for example, Columbia, Cornell, Georgia Tech, and Stanford. Here we do interesting and impactful research. Our faculty has won numerous awards in academia. Also, our department has a strong local and global impact. We've produced excellent alumni in the industry and academia. Our professors have a lot of deep collaborations with real industry, for example, Huawei, SF Express, Covestro, and fintech companies working on interesting projects. Around 92% of our students get employed right after graduation. 7% pursue further study in top universities in US, UK, or other regions. As you can see from the design of our core, we also provide our students with the right foundation for them to pursue postgraduate studies. As an example, IEDA has now negotiated terms to secure spots at top universities for IEDA graduates with high GPAs. So now our students can go, for example, to Columbia University and enroll in some of the very high-level master programs. Our graduates are in high demand in a wide range of sectors, including banking and finance, business and management. We have exchange partners globally. In the past, our students have exchanged at top universities around the world. In particular, I want to emphasize that we have established a good and close relationship with Northwestern. We also have very similar curriculum design so that the students who exchange there will have a very smooth transition. Northwestern has teaching staff help our students settle down and have a wonderful student life there. We encourage our students to find all kinds of internships. Since our department has very good connections with all kinds of industries locally in Hong Kong and globally, we also try our best to recommend our students to intern at various places. However, for the top places, for example, Goldman Sachs, students need to actively get involved in the job search process and have a solid skill set that they learned from our curriculum. Here are a few pictures of our students taking internships. The mentorship program is also a big part of our curriculum. As I have mentioned, many alumni have become very successful in their career. We invite them back to serve as mentors, so large portion of mentors are actually our successful alumni. But of course, we don't restrict the mentors within the population of our alumni. Every year, we have our annual dinner with the mentors, so mentors and mentees can chat and talk. We also organize small group meetings. Every couple of weeks, we would like to invite one or two mentors back to our campus on a Saturday afternoon to chat with three or four mentees. And our students can learn a lot from the real experience of our mentors. Our students have won numerous student competition awards. Here are just a few examples. If you want to apply solid skills to change the world by making it a better place, if you find any of the above domain areas interesting to you, I'd like to encourage you to sign up for our program. We look forward to providing a wonderful platform for our students and raise our students to a whole new level in the knowledge economy. Here are the contact information of our department, including social network, Facebook, and Instagram. Please feel free to contact us should you have any questions. Our society is undergoing rapid changes caused by the advancement of information technology and the availability of huge amount of data. The challenge is how to create values by utilizing vast amount of data in business areas. The difference between winners and losers across all different areas lies between the ability of using data, model, and analysis to make smart decisions. If you find what we are doing exciting and interesting, I look forward to see you on the campus of HKUST. Thank you.